It's the site of the UPDF soldiers carrying heavy machine guns that welcomes you here at Two Padach Trading Center in Amuru sub-county. The soldiers are standing under the verandas while others are under the trees. This area is filled with fear and death.
A community that was involved in conflict of land, and consequently it led to loss of lives. We went to restore normalcy, we went to give them guarantee, to provide them the necessary safety, the security they needed, to continue their regular work. We went to give them assurance that government is committed to ensure that they live peacefully.
A few feet behind the trading center is another bigger crowd. The people of Chamgot village in Achwera parish have gathered under a huge tree to meet the security leadership of the district. This follows the death of two people in land clashes.
This land conflict has led to death. If one party refuses to divide the land, what will you do?
The Saturday violent clashes involved the clans of Paingo and Puche. The dead are Sarafino Lakony, who was 70 years old, and Julius Ochaya.
We've given them the assurance, I am happy. Normalcy is returning, and regrettably and painfully, we have two bodies that have been lost that we have to ensure the burial is a success. And I think together the community is happy to get involved in the process to bury their loved one.
The violent land clashes also led to the destruction of an unknown number of houses. Some of them were burnt down. This is a conflict that has been ongoing for the last 23 years. The residents here are now requesting for protection from the office of the RDC.
I trust that the previous leaders would have sorted this land conflict, but nothing happened. Will you help us? If you put both sides on a round table, but they fail to agree, where will you take this matter?
The meeting was organized by the district RDC Odong Stephen Latek, and it was also attended by the district police commander and the UPDF. The local leaders like Akena Amos are also emphasizing on the need for the government to construct a police station within Achwera parish in order to calm the situation.
These issues, it took long, about 23 years now. So with this one, you know, last time, very many leaders have been trying to solve this case.
The Honorable Akena Amos, who is the LOC3 councillor representing the people of Achwera parish, believes that there is a need to divide his parish as it is too large for proper service delivery. The land conflict across Amuru district has been partly blamed on the lack of boundaries in the customary land. These conflicts have escalated after the people returned from the IDP camps in 2006.
To ensure that they live peacefully and they're productively involved in making money. As the president always says, let's involve in productive activities and make good use of the land to make money.
Poverty and ignorance have also been identified as contributing factors to the increasing land-related violence in Amuru district. I'm Joseph Omago reporting for the news in Amuru district.